In the last video, we talked about vector spaces, and we said what a vector space was and gave some examples of vector spaces. Now, one of the best places to find vector spaces is sitting inside of other vector spaces. So, for example, if you let R sub 2 of t be the set of all quadratic polynomials, all things of the form a plus bt plus ct squared, and you let R3 of t be all cubic polynomials, all things of the form a plus bt plus ct squared plus dt cubed, then you realize that every quadratic polynomial is also a cubic polynomial. You know, x squared plus t squared plus 7 is the same thing as 0t cubed plus t squared plus 7. It's just a cubic polynomial where the t cubed term is 0. And if we let R of t be all polynomials, then you see every quadratic polynomial is also a cubic polynomial, and every cubic polynomial is a polynomial. So we have one vector space sitting inside of another vector space sitting inside of a third vector space. The terminology we use for this is subspaces. We say R lower t is the space of quadratic polynomials is a subspace of the space of cubics. The cubics is a subspace of the space of all polynomials. The quadratics is a subspace of the space of all polynomials. However, watch out. R2, that's the space of all pairs of numbers. Is that a subspace of all triples of numbers? No. Something with two numbers in it doesn't have three numbers in it. R2 is not a subspace of R3. Even though R lower 2 is a subspace of R lower 3. Okay, so if I give you a vector space V, and I give you a subset of V, let's call that subset W, is it a subspace? A subspace is something that is a vector space in its own right. Well, if I give you any two points in W, you know what it means to add them because they're in V, and you know how to add any two things in V. But what they might not be is in W. You have to be able to add things in W to get something in W. Just to say, W has to be closed under addition. That means the sum of any two things in W has to also be in W. Likewise, you know what it means to multiply something in W by a scalar. But it's not necessarily in W. You better hope it's in W for scalar multiplication to make sense as an operation in W. And then finally, you don't want W to be the empty set. And another way of saying that is you want the zero vector to be in W. You see, if W contains at least one non-zero element, then when you multiply it by zero, you get the zero vector. If you have the zero vector in there, then that's an element. So W being non-empty and W containing zero, some people use these three axioms, some people use these three axioms, and they work the same way. This is probably the better one to think of abstractly. This is the easier one to check. So now let's look at some examples. Our first example is if I give you an M by N matrix, the null space of that matrix is a set of all vectors in Rn for which Ax is 0. And that's a subspace of Rn. How can we tell it's a subspace? Well, let's see. If x and y are in there, that means that Ax is 0 and Ay is 0. A times x plus y is Ax plus Ay, so that's 0 plus 0, that's 0, it works. X plus y is in the space. Likewise, any multiple of x is in the space because a times cx is c times ax, which is c times 0. So this is closed under addition, it's closed under scalar multiplication, and it contains the 0 vector because a times 0 is 0. Hooray, it's a subspace. No matter what the matrix is, the null space is a subspace. Next thing, let's look in R2. And consider all vectors in R2 such that x1 plus x2 is 0. This is, well, let's see, if you take any two vectors along this line and add them, you get something else that's along this line. You rescale something, it's still on this line. And in fact, this is a special case, and it goes through the origin. And this is in fact a special case of the previous example with A being 1, 1. Because 1, 1 times x1, x2 is just x1 plus x2. We're looking for all things where x1 plus x2 is 0. That's the subspace. It's the null space of the matrix 1, 1. Next example, let's look at x1 plus x2 equals 1. That's not closed under addition. Here's the point 1, 0. Here's the point 0, 1. If you add them, you get 1, 1, which isn't in W. It's also not closed under scalar multiplication. If you multiply this by 2, you get 2, 0, which isn't in W. And it doesn't contain the origin. Three strikes and you're out. This is not a subspace of R2. Next example. W is the coordinate axes. Everything on the x-axis, everything on the y-axis. That's closed under scalar multiplication because if you take something here and you rescale it, you get something else on the x-axis. If you take something here and you rescale it, you get something on the y-axis. But it's not closed under addition. If 1, 0, and 0, 1, their sum is 1, 1, which isn't on the coordinate axes. Not closed under addition, it's not a subspace. How about the first quadrant? Let's say including the boundary. It contains 0. It's closed under addition if you take something here and add it to something here. By the parallelogram rule, you get something that's in the first quadrant, but it's not closed under scalar multiplication. If you take something here and multiply it by negative 1, you get something that's not in the first quadrant. Remember, when we rescale things, what we're rescaling by can be negative. Last example, integer points. All the points with integer coordinates. If you add any two of them, you get something with integer coordinates. If you multiply them by negative 3, you get something with integer coordinates. However, if you take a point here and you multiply it by square root of 2, you get something that doesn't have integer coordinates. And so this is not closed under addition, not closed under scalar multiplication. And so this is not a subspace. So of our examples, the only two that were subspaces were the null space of an arbitrary matrix, that was a subspace, and the line x1 plus x2 equals 0. The rest were not subspaces because they failed to meet one or more of the criteria.